Now let's discuss spot removal. You can access the spot removal tool by clicking on the icon at the top in that little toolbar in the develop module. First, I'll discuss the differences between clone and heal. I'll click once on the image and Lightroom is going to try and locate an area where it thinks that I want to actually clone this to. I'm going to move it over to the blue section just to demonstrate this setting. And you can see that Lightroom is creating an exact clone of that area. If I were to click heal, however, Lightroom will retain the color of that original area, but it uses the texture from whatever the sample area is. I recommend that you start out with the heal setting and then move to clone if necessary. The size setting is pretty straightforward. You can change it in this section here. This will change the size of the brush, but it will also change the size if you have any of the cloned areas active in your screen. Feather will adjust how soft or how hard that edge is. And then opacity is pretty straightforward. It just sets the opacity of that section as well. The spot removal tool works best in images where there is a lot of area to sample from, and this is a really good example. It's also a good idea to keep the brush size to as small as necessary in order to get the job done. So I'll just reduce the brush size and click over those balloons off in the background. And Lightroom has no trouble with healing those areas with the surrounding sky. Of course, not all of your photographs are going to be this easy. Other types of images that tend to work better for cloning and healing are images with repeating patterns. You saw me click over an area last time, but another way you can clone or heal is just by clicking and dragging to create an area, and then it will try and sample, and that actually did a very good job of sampling from a similar section. The larger your section is that you're trying to heal or clone, the less likely that Lightroom is going to do a good job. You can see here, it sampled in a strange place. I could try and find another spot if I really wanted to get rid of that. And if I'm unable to find it, then I'll just delete it. Another thing you can do is click, hold the Shift key, and then drag down, and that will create a straight line. This kind of thing works really well with power lines, for example. To delete an adjustment, just make sure it's active and press the Delete key. And then just keep trying until you get a good sample.